Nomi Hoshikawa of Japan had the honor of starting the first medal event of the games. But the honor of leading the way lasted less than 5 minutes, as a more powerful field dusted her in the snow of Les Saisies. In the end, she would be 42nd, but between her start and finish, a chase filled with gold, with personal conflict, was just beginning.
Most maps of France have long forgotten about the tiny village called Les Saisies. Most sports pages in America have also forgotten about the sport of cross-country skiing. But if you believe the cross-country experts, both the village and the sport are about to take a huge step up in terms of recognition because of 23-year-old Russian Yelena Valby. They believe that she can win 5 gold medals on this medal stand, thereby doing for this village and her sport what Eric Heiden did for Lake Placid and speed skating. The reason they think she can do it is she's simply that good.
In an international career that is only 4 years old, Yelena Valby has already won 5 world championship gold medals, 3 of those last year. Twice she won the overall championship of the World Cup circuit, and this season leads with 3 victories in 4 tries. She wins everywhere she goes, living a professional life without a bump. But this is not the case in her personal life, an opera with plenty of soap. While the rest of the sporting world watched the Calgary Olympics, Yelena was giving birth to Franz, now a hockey and soccer playing 4-year-old. This winter, like everyone since his birth, the littlest Valby has been left behind for 5 months with Yelena's parents. Where's dad? He's here in France too, but not with Yelena. They've split up like the Soviet Union because of, among other things, he felt they should both ski for Estonia. He does, she doesn't. Now living in Moscow, having taken up with a team coach, Nikolai Zimatov. Emotions are powerful when it comes to her son. Just stronger, it seems, when it comes to skiing. Today, there was a last-second moment to clear a mind that must be a stormy sea. Yelena's 15-kilometer race to be skied in the sport's classical style was underway. Maybe marriage isn't her perfect relationship, and motherhood, too, is difficult. But Valby and skiing finally meant peace. At 2 kilometers, she was within 2 seconds of the leading pace set by a teammate. Effects of a slight case of the flu wasn't evident, but by the halfway mark, she was 40 seconds behind, and 2 of the world's best conditioned ski legs looked heavy. This was not the form of a gold medalist today, but this was, belonging to Valby's teammate, Lyubov Yegorova, who went on to win gold for the unified team. Yelena's reaction as she approached the line was difficult to detect, until she collapsed in frustrated fatigue. At this moment, she was in the position of silver medalist, but by the time she made her way to the scoreboard, a Finnish skier had nudged her to 3rd, 1 spot away from a champion's oblivion, with the clocks still ticking. It was a different feeling for Norway's Inger Nybråten, who showed a fullness of ability that belied an emptiness she must have felt at the loss of the most influential man in her life, her father, who died on Friday. She skied for him, she said, and remarkably had the heart to finish 7th. Yelena Valby was living on a medalist seesaw. 1 second you're down, saying in German, 4th place. The next you're hopefully up. The last challenging skier was approaching the finish. That was the moment Yelena Valby knew the joy of hanging on to at least win a bronze. But as she embraced her teammates, emotions swelled again. Disappointment, concern, elation, relief, and tears. This is the complex Olympic life of Yelena Valby, just getting started in Les Saisies.
Joining us now is our cross-country expert, Paul Robbins, who's been covering the sport for 14 years. Paul, right after Yelena Valby realized she had won the bronze, she told me in German that she was satisfied and it was super. Do we believe her?
Absolutely, Al. I think if the bad news is that Valby did not win the gold medal, the good news has to be that Valby still won a medal and she's still on track to become the first woman to win 5 medals at the Winter Olympics.
Well, that's news of the future. Tomorrow, it's Bill Koch's turn. He returns to his 4th Winter Olympics, all on our mile-high plateau called Les Saisies.